Right now, dozens of people are camping out for a chance to watch President Donald Trump make his pitch to the people of Nevada. This as Democrats make their final push ahead of tomorrow's Democratic caucus.
And all of those events are really turning Las Vegas into the center of the political universe. 13 Action News reporter Sean DeLancey joins us live near the convention center where the president will take the stage in just a few hours. Sean.
Yeah, Kalina and Ross, this is exactly what you would expect from a Trump rally. People spending a cold night outside for their chance to see the president here, and they say that they are camping out to try and not miss this venue in case it overfills, which it often does at rallies like these. One supporter said that he is here also to try and bond with a lot of the people that share his values.
I like to be up in the front row. I enjoy that, but more so, I enjoy getting here early to share the stories and hear why all the other people in line now support Donald Trump.
Now, Trump is wading into the fray here as the men and women who want his job make one last pitch to the people in Nevada before tomorrow's caucus. With the Democrats, it's a battle of moderates like Joe Biden, Pete Buttigieg, and Amy Klobuchar against the more left-leaning candidates like Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren. Just yesterday, Warren spent the day meeting with voters at local spots like Ella M's Soul Food in North Las Vegas. The senator then took part in a town hall with Vice President Joe Biden, where she defended her more liberal policies like the 2% wealth tax as a proper solution for struggling people in the country.
But it is supported by Democrats, independents, and Republicans. Get that. This is something that is popular across America. Why? Because Americans, regardless of party affiliation, understand they're getting the short end of the stick.
Now, despite qualifying for the dim debate in Las Vegas, billionaire Mike Bloomberg is not on the ballot here in Nevada. Trump's rally begins here at noon again, and we should find out who wins Nevada tomorrow evening. Sean DeLancey, 13 Action News.